So this is my life run of 25 capacity. So weekly we have to do this inspection as per my PMS. So first of all, we have to check all the instructions and it is there or not. So there should be your, it is ship specific. Means you have all the details of your ship's particulars, your name, then IMO number. So it is always printed here. See, my flag is written here. So they have given maximum storage height also. So you cannot store this more than 25 meters. So for my vessel and this deck, it is 15 meters requirement. So this is acceptable. They have given a painter length also, the length of this painter. So most of the time I have seen it is around 50 meters, but for this ship it is 36. So, and the second thing, the expiry dates, and of course the serial number also. So second thing is operating instructions, how to operate the life raft, means launching of the life raft. So here I have manual launching, I don't have any David launch for this life raft. This is a container, in this we will get particulars of the ships, which flag, name. Second thing, in this we have to check the HRU. So most of the time the PSA are giving remark on this, that the HRU is not connected properly. So it's very important point to check in the life raft. First of all, we will check the expiry date. So my expiry date is up to 2022, so it is valid. And one more thing, when we are receiving this HRU, with this HRU we are they have providing the instructions also, how to make this arrangement, HRU arrangement. So that poster is important. If you follow that one, you will never make a mistake. So here in this, most of the time the people making mistake in connecting the painter. So painter has to be connected to the weak link, and this is our weak link. If you see here, this is the weak link, this orange part here. So this is the weak link in this. Most of the time the guys misunderstand between the weak link and the rope. So this rope is not the weak link, it is cut by the HRU. Once the vessel is sinking 4 meters, it will automatically cut the rope, and then still this painter will be connected to your weak link. Okay, so this is the way how to rig the HRU.
Okay, that's it. So normally when you receive after annual shore servicing, normally people, because annual shore servicing you will remove all these flashings and all. So normally then people make mistakes while we pass this securing back. So they make mistakes. So always check that you are lashing. This is once you join on board, you check this, because once you have checked, you don't have to check again and again. So this is only one time check.
So with our weekly routine of life raft inspection, we also inspect that life raft launching instructions or procedures and IMO symbols are in good condition. So this is a requirement that near life raft or on the same deck, we must have a life raft launching procedures and IMO symbols below an emergency life. So this is the requirement. So that's why we will look for any launching procedure IMO symbol if they are faded away or they are torn out. If that is the case, then we will replace it with a good or a new launching instruction and with a new IMO symbol or a sticker. So as you can see in the above video, third officer has replaced the old life raft launching procedures with a new one. Same we will do with IMO symbols. Thank you.